I am your teacher Jeevita. In this video, you will be seeing the exercise problem for exercise 7.1, that is factors and multiples lesson. So all of you will open your textbook. Page number 136, exercise 7.1. So in the previous video, we have learned all the things about factors and multiples. That is, what is factors, how to find factors using two methods, prime method and division method, and how to find common factors, and how to find HCF, LCM and all these things. And we also learned prime number and composite number. So what is a prime number? I have to revise it now because you will be using it for your exercise problems. So prime numbers are numbers having factors 1 and itself. Example 5. 5 is having factors 5 and 1. So these two are the factors of 5. Other than these two numbers, you don't have any factors for 5. So only it is called prime number. Okay? You have only two types of any numbers. Prime number. If it is not prime number, then it is a composite number. Example, I'll take 6. What are the factors for 6? 1, 6, 3, 2. All these are factors for 6. So, it is a composite number. Means, if it has more than 2 common factors, more than 2 factors, it is a composite number. If it has only 2 factors, that is 1 and the number itself, it is called prime factor. So, next we will go for the exercise problem, and as we do the sums, I will recap the concepts, children. So, if you see the first name, find all the factors of the following numbers by multiplication method. So, how to find the factors? Means, you have to see this number, in whichever table it comes, you have to write that, okay? Means multiplication method. So I write 1, 12 is a 12. First I start from 1. So 12 is a factor. Now I take 2. 2 into 1 is a 2, 6 is 12. So 2 is a factor and 6 is also a factor. Now I'll go for 3 tables. 3, 4 is 12. I got 3 and 4 here, factors. When I go for 4 ones, again I get 4 and 3 only as factors. But I have already got them here. So, I will not go more than this, children. When I get the factors repeated, I will stop there. I won't go further. So, what are the factors now? The numbers here and the numbers here are the factors of 12. So, let me write the factors, that is 1, 2 and 3. Now, go from here, 4, 6 and 12. So, I found all the factors using multiplication method. Now, this is for first one, we will go for second one here, that is 18. So, now let's find the factors for 18 using multiplication method. So first I start from 1, 1, 1. 1, 18 da is 18. Let's go for 2, 1, da. 2, 9 da is 18. Let's go for 3, 1, da. 3, can I have 18 in 3, 1, da? 3, 6 da is 18. When you go for 4, 1, da, you don't have 18 in 4, 1, da. So I'll not go. When I go for 5 ones up, I don't have 18 in 5 ones up also. So, I will not take 5 ones up. Next, I should go for 6 ones up. But I already have 6 as my factor. So, I will stop there. So, what is the factors for 18 I got? 1, 2, 3 and then 6, 9, 18. These are the factors. So, let me write the factors now. 1, 2, 3, 6, 9, 18. These are the factors for 18. Now let's go for 96. So 96, what are the factors? So first start from 1, 1 the 196 the 96. 2, 1 the if you go 2, 2 the. So if you multiply 2, 1 the with 48, if you multiply 2 with 48, you get 96. How to find this, children? You can simply divide this with 2. 96 divided by 2. If you divide, you will get the number. Now we'll go for 3, 1 the. Will I get this in 3, 1 the? Yes. When I divide, I get 3, 3s are 9, 3, 2s are 6. So I got the answer. Now let's go for 4, 1 the and check whether it is divisible. Yes, you can divide this, that is 2, 24. 4, 24 the 96. Next we'll go for 5 tables. It can't go in 5 tables because unit places, not 5. You have learnt it in divisibility test. For dividing with 5, my unit place should be 0 or 5. So now let's go for 6, 1 the. Do I get it in 6, 1 the? Let me check. 96 divided by 6. 6, 1 the 6, 3, 6. Yes, I can divide it by 6. So it is 6, 16 the 96. Now next I should go for 7 tables. Now check whether it is divisible by 7. 7, 1 the 7, 2, 6. No, it is not divisible because 26 doesn't come in 7, 1 the. Let's go for 8, 1 the now. 8 and divide by 96. Yes, it goes in 8, 1 the tables, that is 12. So I write it up here. 8 into 12 is 96. In 9, 1 the you get it? No, you don't get in 9, 1 the. Not in 10, 1 the also because it is not 0 in units place. In 11, 1 the also you don't get. So if I go for 12, I already have the factor here. So I will stop it. When I get this factor repeated, I will stop. So now what are the factors? We'll start from here and then continue here. Okay? We'll start from here and continue here. So what are the factors I found? 8, 12, okay, 8, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. Next, I'll write 8 children here because I didn't have place here, so I wrote here, no. So I'm writing 8 now. 8, after that, I should write 12. 12, next comes 16, 24, and then what is there? 24, 32, 48. And 96. So 96 has so many multiples, sorry, factors. Okay children, the other sums you should try it out and you should say me the answer, children. Let me see who will work out all the sums and will say me the answer voluntarily, means without me asking you. Now go for the second mean. Find the prime factors of the following by factor tree method. You learn that finding factors by prime method, no children? That is also called factor tree. So let me take the number first. And now I should write, first I should see in 2, 1 the. So in 2, 1 the, will I get 27? No. So let me take 3, 1 the here. So 3, 9 is 27. Now I should divide 9 again. I can't divide 3 because I get only 1 and 3. So I will divide 9. If I divide this 9, I will get 3, 3 is 9. Again I got the same number which I cannot divide more because it is a prime number. If it is a prime number, I can't divide it like again and again. So these are the factors which I got using prime factors or prime or tree factor method, factor tree method. So this is the first one. We go for second one now. So take 36. Okay, now let's divide that into 2. You have, first let me go with 2 on the table. So 2 1s are 2 8s are. So 2 18s are 36. Now I will divide. dividing further. 2 is a prime number, so I will not divide it further. I will get here. Again, I start with 2 ones only because I can divide 18 with 2 ones. So 2 9 is 18. Now divide 9 again. 9, it comes in 3 ones, right? So I'm going to take 3. So 3 3 is 9. Now I can't go further because I got a prime number. Now go with the 8th one, children. I felt 8th one would be difficult for you, so I am doing 8th one. Here also 6th one. I am not going in order. Check the question number and then solve it. So 8th one is 72. So let me divide it first with 2 ones. So what do I get? 2, 3 is 6, 2 6 is. So if you divide 72 with 2, you get 36. That means 2 36 is 72. Now divide 36 further. Again I can divide it with 2 ones. So I get 18. You can see 36 here. So it is 2 and 18 first. Further what do you get? Same like this. 2 here, 9 here. And then if I go further, I'll get 3 and 3. So I have solved 3 sums. Other sums you should work it out and show me the textbook. Okay? Now we'll go for the third way.
Find the common factors of. So you know how to find common factors, right? You can use any one method in this two method. You can use the prime factor method or you can use division method also. I am using division method here. So if I use 6 division method, I get 2, 3, 6. Again 3, 1, 3. So what are the factors for 6 here? So factors for 6, I can take as prime factors. So I will write P and 6 as a sub number. P and 6. So prime factor for 6 is 3, 2. 3 and 2. Now again take the next number 18. Find the factors for them. It is 2, 9 is 18. 3, 3 is 9. 3, 1 is 3. So what are the prime factors for 18 I got? 2, 3, 3. I can write as 3, 3, 2. 2, 3 and 1, 2. So what is common here? The 3 is common in this. So my common factor is 3. Common factor for 6 and 18 is 3. So now let's go for the E one. Because you have 3 numbers here. How to find for 3 numbers? Similarly to this. Means how do you find the factors here? I found it for only 2, no? Then we find it for 3 and then circle the common in that. So what is the factors for 10? I can get the factors like 2, 5, 5, 1, da. So factor is 2 and 5. Now take the factors for 25. It is only 5 and 5. So factors for 25. P factors for 25 is 5 and 5. Now factors for 40. It is 2 20s, 2 10s, and factors for 10 I already know, 2 and 5. So it will be like factors for 40 is 2, 2 and 2 and 5. So what is the number which is common in all the 3 here? 5, 5, 5. So the common factor of this 3 number is 5. Now let's go for the 4th main. Check the divisibility by 2.
So now we have learned the divisibility in the previous video. That is, if it is divisible by 2, then its units place should be 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. In this, any number should be in the units place. Apart from that, if you have any other number like 1, 3, then it is not divisible by 2. So I have 8 here. Yes, so it is write 98 is divisible by 2. But you write this in the class of children, in the textbook. If it is divisible, just put a tick on that number. Okay. If it's not divisible, then put a wrong mark in the number. I saw 98 is divisible, and even B1, because I have 4 in the units place, I can tick this also. Other numbers we can see here,
if you go for the C1, you have 3 in the units place. So that is not divisible. You will put a wrong mark for it. Now go for the fifth main. Check the divisibility by 3. So you have to check for 3.
How to check that? You have to add all these numbers and the answer you get should be in 3 1s are table. So let me show you how. 3 plus 4 is 7, 7 plus 2 is 9. So do I get 9 in 3 1s are table? I get. So 342 is divisible by 3. Now let's check for B. 1 plus 2 plus 5. I get answer 7. Do I have 7 in 3 1s? No. So this is not divisible by 3. Now we will go for F1. Because you have 4 numbers here, I have chosen the question. That is, I will take the 4 numbers, add 1 plus 0 plus 2 plus 5. So what is the answer I get? 1 plus 0, 1, 0, 1 plus 2, 3, 3 plus 5, 8. My answer is 8. Do I get 83 tables? No. So this is also not divisible by 3. Now go for the next name.
Children, you have to see the next numbers and mark. I am going for next main now. Sixth main. Check the divisibility by 5.
So this is very easy, children. If you have 0 or 5 in the units place, then it is divisible. If not, it is not divisible. You can see having 5 here, 75 has 5 in the unit place. So this is divisible. And 434. You have 4 in the units place, it's not 5 or 0, so it is not divisible. Now go for the next 7th name.
Write the prime numbers between 1 to 10. First one, 1 to 10.
So you know what is prime numbers, no children? It should have factors like 1 and the number only. You should not have more than 2 factors for it. So like that, how many you have in from 1 to 10? You can see 1 is not, okay, I have to say one important thing. 1 is called unit factor. It is not a prime factor also. It is not a composite number also. So I will not take 1 as consideration. So let me take 2. Yes, 2 is a prime factor because it can have factors 1 and 2 only. 3 is a prime factor. 5 is a prime factor. 7 is a prime factor. From 1 to 10, I have only these many prime factors. So let us go for next. I have taken E question. Children, which is easy for you, I have left it to work it out. This is difficult, I am doing it here. So I have to find prime factors between 30 and 50. So let us check 31. 31 is a number, it can be divisible by any other tables. No, 31 can be divisible only by 1 1 and 31 1. So 31 is the prime factor. 32 is not a prime factor. 33 is not a prime factor. 34, 35, 36, 37. So 37 is the prime factor. 37 is the prime factor. And then 38 and 39 is also not a 37, 39, and I can see 40, 41, 40. 41 is the prime factor, children. And then I can get 43 as a prime factor. 43, 44, 45, 46, 47. 47 is also a prime factor. 38, 49. So 49 is also a prime factor. So these many prime factors I have from 30 to 50. So let us take from 25 to 50 now. 25 can be divided by 5 ones and all, so it's not considered. 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31. So in the F1 children, that is 25 to 50, I have 29 as prime factor, 30 prime factor, and the rest all you can find in the previous one only, 31, 37, 41, etc. Now we'll go for the next main, that is 8th main.
For 8th main, you have to find the prime factors. So you have two methods to find prime factors, right? You can use any one method and find the prime factors for this. Here I'm going to take the biggest number like 108 and 120 and I'll show you how to find. Okay, rest you will be working.
I'll take 120 here. I'm using the division method. That is 260 is 120, 230 is 60, 215 is 30, 2, I can't take 2 ones, I take 3 ones, 3 5s are 15, 5 ones are 5. I stop when I get 1. So what are the prime factors for 120 I got? 5, 3, 2, 2 and 2. So these are the prime factors. So you have to work out the rest children, it is not so difficult. So you can try it in your, try it by yourself and check the answer. Now we'll go for 9th main, find the HCF.
Go for the 9th main children, that is find the HCF of the following by prime factor method.
So let's find the HCF in prime factor method. Means we have to take the factors for 12, prime factors for 12, prime factor for 18 and prime factor for 24. So what are the factors for 12 here? If I should do prime factor means I should divide like this children, prime method. So I get 2 6 the 2 3 the 3 1 the. So prime factor for 12 is 2 2 3. Similarly, prime factor for 18 is 2 9 the 3 3 the 3 1 the. So 2 3 3. Now prime factors for 24. So it will be same like 12 children. If I take 24, I divide by 2, I get 12. So you can see the prime factors here for 12. This also will be same. So my prime factor for 24 is 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. Now what should I find? I have to find the highest common factor. How to find that? I have to circle the common factors here. Rest, it is not common in everything. Okay, so I am finding only 2 and 3 as common factor. So when I multiply this 2, I get 6 as the answer. 6 is the highest common factor. Children, any doubt, I'll be clearing it in the interactive session, children. Okay, we will do a revision also in the revision classes. Now, we'll go for the 10th main.
I have taken the E sum in both the mains because it has 3-3 numbers. Others have 2-2 numbers. You know how to find them. We'll go for the E1 because it has 3 numbers.
In this main, you have to find LCM. LCM to find, I don't need to divide it separately like this. I take all the numbers together and find my factors. So all are divisible by 5. 5 3 is a, 5 4 is a, 5 1 is a. Now this is all not common. 5 5 is a 25, 5 4 is a 20, 5 3 is a 15. Now this is all not common, so I should take separately one by one. So first I divide 3 with 3, 1 the, 3, 1 the, 3. Now 4 I can't divide, I'll write it as it is. 5 also I can't divide, so I'll write as it is. Now I'll divide 4 now. 1, I already got 1, so I'll write it. Now I'll divide 4, 1 the, 4. Now 5 I'll divide it in the next step. 5. 1 the 1 the 1 the. So I get all 1's here, I stop. So now how to find the LCM? I simply multiply all the numbers which I have got in this left side. So it is 5 into 3 into 4 into 5. So what is the answer I get? 5 3 is 15, 5 4 is 20, 20 into 5 is 2 5 is 30, take the 0. zero directly here. So my answer is 300. So this is the LCM of these three numbers. Children, LCM I will be doing it in the revision class. Again, I'm saying because of less time, I'm showing you one sum here. In the interactive session, I'll explain it again, and even in the revision classes, we will do the sums. Okay. Now we'll go for the next exercise 7.2, and we take the first mean. The first mean is you have to find the multiples, the four multiples of the following. What is multiples, my children? You will multiply any number with this and take the answer and write it. So I multiply 100 with 2, I get 200. So this is the multiple. Like that, I multiply 3 with 100, I get 300. This is the multiple. Like that, I get 4 when I get multiplied with 4. I also get 500 when I multiply with 5. Like this, you simply multiply this number with 1, 2, 3, 4 and write the multiples. So I am showing you one more, that is C1. This is B1, this is C1. So if I multiply with 2, I get 40. Multiply with 3, I get 60. Multiply with 4, I get 80. Multiply with 5, I get 100. I will stop it because I need only 4 multiples. Now go for the second main.
What is second main about? Select the even numbers and circle them. You have to circle the even numbers, children. First of all, what is even numbers?
Numbers having 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. These are even numbers, and any number having this number in the unit's place is an even number. So 8 is an even number. 12, it has 2 in the unit's place. This is also an even number. 5, no. 15 is not even number because it has 5. 19 is not even number. So this 2 is an even number. Now go for B1. 18 is an even number and 64 is an even number. Now next thing, it is odd numbers. Circle the odd numbers. So I write what are the odd numbers here? 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. These are the odd numbers. So you have any number in the unit space here that you have to circle. This is not an odd number. 17, you see 7 here. So it is an odd number. This is also an odd number. 28 is not an odd number. Go for the second one. 29 is an odd number. 37 is also an odd number. Next you have fourth mean, skip countings. You know what is skip counting for children? Nothing but tables. Skip counting means it's equal to tables. If I ask you to write skip countings of 2, you will see 2 on the table. That is, what are the answers you get in 2 on the? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. These are the skip countings in 2. If I ask you in 5, you will say 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. Like that, I am asking you to write skip countings of 100. So in 100, what is the skip counting? 100, 200, 300, 400, 500. So these are the skip countings. So this is skip counting, children. You can write many numbers as much as you can, but here you are going to write only number. They have given you blanks here. How many blanks you have, only so many numbers you are going to fill in that. Okay. Next, we'll go for one more problem, that is multiples of 10. That is very easy. 10, they have given you 50. They have started from 50. Okay, now count after 50 with tens. 50, I get 60, 70, 80, 90, 100 and as on.
So, from where they have given, from there you should start skipping, okay? You cannot start from 20. Okay, children, by this we have completed the factors and multiples lesson. I know you will be having lots of confusion because this is the starting you are seeing this chapter. You see this video again and again, children, only then you will understand the concepts. Okay, we'll meet you.